Hello and welcome to the Zebra Transportation and Logistics in the Hot Seat video. I'm Lindsay Drouse, a supplier business manager here at ScanSource, dedicated to Zebra. I'm here with my colleagues, Eric Williams, who has been in the industry for 22 years. Three of those years have been in his current role as the senior manager of North America, Tablet, Rugged Field Services and Utilities. And Doug Robbins, the senior account manager of Rugged Field Services, who has worked in the rugged tablet industry for 17 years. 10 of those years have been focused in the utilities market space. They are here to answer questions about how you can grow your utilities business with Zebra and ScanSource. Welcome, Eric and Doug.
Hey, thank you, Lindsay.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Absolutely. So let's get started with you, Eric. Can you give us an update on the tablet market and where Zebra is making investments in the utility space?
Sure. And thank you again, Lindsay, and ScanSource for hosting us. We really appreciate it. Where Zebra's focused, we've been extremely successful. We're number one in data capture technologies. We're number one in mobile computing, number one in barcode printing, and number one in mobile RFID. We make significant investments in our tablet portfolio, as well as huge investments in building a team of nine that focuses on tablet opportunities in North America. And seven of nine of my team specifically focuses on opportunities in the utilities market as a part of their rugged field service accounts. We're gaining a ton of momentum in the rugged tablet market, and we're poised to be number two in market share position at the completion of 2021. So we're super excited about that.
Great. Thanks, Eric, for that update. Now, Doug, recently, we've been hearing more and more about the utilities market and how resellers can grow within that space. Where are you seeing opportunity in this space?
Before we get into that, I want to make sure you guys understand the scope of business within the utility sector for it, here in the United States, at least. So when you think of utilities, there's almost 3,000 utility companies in the U.S. You got munis, you have rural electric co-ops, city-owned utilities, but we're really focused on this team and for this call specifically is what I call investor-owned utility companies. Those are large investor-owned utility companies that have, you know, 1,000 employees, large operations, and those are roughly 170 to 215 companies, depending on how you slice it up. So a lot of mergers and acquisitions in this space. So, you know, working for Eric, we've defined roughly, you know, that one, you know, 150 to 200 roughly utility companies that we're going after today. So I just want to make sure we have a definition of what an investor-owned utility company is versus some of the smaller munis and co-ops. Although those could be good places for some of our partners to potentially go after, our focus is on the larger ones. So your question about where to go, we've defined a lot of different areas in terms of you know, where we could look at. A lot of them right now is enhancing customer experience. So a lot of that requires mobility, could be tablets, could be handhelds in that area. Smart metering is another area that we're seeing growth that allows customers to track usage and manage you know, energy out in the field. Managing legacy infrastructure. So that's a lot of areas of growth there as well. And then one that we've seen is managing the mobile workforce. So a lot of these utility companies, most of their employees are out in the field and they need devices to manage what they're doing on day-to-day operations. So those are some of the areas that we're seeing in terms of growth in the utility sector and where your partners could expect to go on.
Okay, that is great insight, Doug. So based off some of the opportunities that Doug shared, Eric, can you tell us how can Zebra and ScanSource partners gain access into these markets?
Sure, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'll tie into some of, you know, what Doug had mentioned as well. So, you know, this wasn't a space that our traditional partners have engaged with in the past, unless they were engaged in a warehouse type scenario, driving inventory, asset management type solutions, where we sold our MCs, our TCs, our print, and our RFID line of products. Tablets are truly getting us engaged in a whole new game, whether it be in replacing legacy hard mount forklift devices in the warehouses, driving management productivity, as well as Doug mentioned, driving field service opportunities, where large CRMs are providing visibility to their utility clients for sales, for vendor management, for inventory planning, and overall field execution. So the key is finding hooks that our partners are going to be able to tie into these CRMs and providing solutions that drive efficiencies within the workflows.
All right, so that's a great segue kind of to my next question. How are current resellers selling into the utilities market today? And where are you seeing that room for growth? Doug, I'm gonna let you take this one.
Well, right now, our current buyers, I'd say a lot of different areas that they could be looking at within large utility companies. I have to find like four or five of them. One of them is generation. So the generation plants, and that's operator rounds, inspections, equipment maintenance, and they have to track tools in and out of warehouses. A lot of these tools are very expensive, and they got to make sure that when they leave, they're tracking them. So a lot of that's with our tablet portfolio. We're looking at growing in that area. Transmission. You see transmission all over. It could be outage management, substation repairs. So a lot of this is maybe foreign to some of our partners, but these are large utility companies. They all pretty much have the same operations. Another one we're talking about is fleets. So if you look at fleet management within utility companies, some of these utility companies could have as many as 10,000 trucks out there. So they have to have some type of mobility in that truck. Typically, it's going to be mounted. It's going to be some type of device that's in the truck. It's going to be mounted. It's going to have power. They need outdoor readability. So that's another area. And one that I think a lot of people don't really think about is vegetation management. So you need mapping software. You need to make sure you got the coordinates when you're trying to make sure that that your power lines are free of any growth from trees and such as that. So when there's then having power outages from storms. So there's a lot of different areas that we could that for growth to look at for our customers in the utility business.
Okay, yeah, that's some great insight there as well. As we wrap up, I do have one last question for you, Eric. How does the Zebra tablet portfolio play into this market?
I definitely appreciate the question, Lindsay. So as mentioned in the opening, Zebra continues to make significant investments in our tablet portfolio. A part of Zebra's strategy is platforming, providing our customers with the ability to leverage our peripheral ecosystem and make them backwards compatible where possible. Our ET5 product portfolio is selling at record levels. And then also we are continuing to make investments in our next gen, where we will be making investments in our next gen L10, which is super. And then also, stay tuned for additional announcements regarding new form factors that will be coming to the market within the near term. So can't share that now, but just a little plug. We're super excited. Again, we are investing heavily within the market. In all Zebra's traditional portfolio and the intense focus that we've been placing on our expansion products, which includes our tablet portfolio, it's driving opportunities within new business segments, including utilities. And these investments are starting to pay dividends for our partner community.
Okay, awesome. I wish you told us a little bit more about that tablet, but we'll stay tuned for that.
More to come.
More to come.
Continue to make investments. We have a fantastic portfolio currently, and that portfolio is going to continue to expand.
Awesome. Well, I just want to say thank you both, Eric and Doug, for your insight and knowledge today.
Thanks for having me.
And then thank you all who have joined us today for the installment of In the Hot Seat. We hope you found it informative and useful.